JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for December the 15th. I am Charalambos, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded mixed against the other digital currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It gained against the Aussie, the Kiwi, the Yen and the Canadian dollar in that order, while it underperformed versus SEC, NOK, CHF, GBP and the Euro. The weakening of the Aussie and the Kiwi combined with the strengthening of the Swiss franc suggests that markets turned risk off at some point yesterday. However, the weakening of the Japanese yen points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, all but one of the major EU indices traded in the green, with the only exception being UK's FTSE 100. It seems that European investors may have cheered the decision between EU and UK negotiators to extend talks over a potential trade deal. The FTSE 100 may have lost ground due to the strengthening of the British pound. That said, sentiment changed during the US session, with both the Dow Jones and the S&P 500 losing 0.62 and 0.44% respectively, although the former hit a fresh record high early in the session. Nasdaq gained 0.50%. The soft sentiment rolled over into the Asian session today as well, and this may have been the result of reports saying that China has banned imports of Australian coal. In any case, yesterday's setback in equities does not change our view. We still believe that at the turn of the year, risk on is likely to prevail. The beginning of the vaccinations suggests that the worst with regards to the coronavirus may be behind us, but this is conditional upon no side effects. While another positive for market sentiment may be a Biden presidency in the US, as the new president is expected to adopt a softer stance on global trade than Trump did. Thus, even if the current retreat continues for a while more, we would just consider it as end of year profit taking, and we would expect a rebound soon. In the FX world, the pound opened its Monday trading with a large positive gap on the headlines with regards to the extension of the trade talks, and kept drifting north after EU Brexit negotiator Michel Barnier said that sealing a trade pact with Britain before December 31st was still possible. That said, the British currency gave back a decent portion of its gains later in the afternoon. Even though there is a Bank of England gathering on this week's agenda, as well as several UK data, we stick to our guns that the pound is likely to stay mostly sensitive to headlines and developments surrounding the political landscape. Anything suggesting that the two sides are getting closer in sealing a trade accord could result in more positive waves, while reports hinting that the differences gap is not narrowing could hurt the currency. Now, flying from the UK to Australia, the Aussie was the main loser among the G10s, hurt by the news that China banned imports of Australian coal. Australia's and China's trading ties have been very tight, at least until now, and such developments raise concerns over their future relationship. Nonetheless, if the reports are not confirmed, or if this is just a sole incident that does not escalate further, we would expect the Aussie to rebound at some point soon, even if it corrects a bit lower. As we already noted, we believe that the broader market sentiment will stay supported, something that would keep the risk-linked Aussie under buying interest especially against safe havens like the US dollar and the Japanese yen. Now, as for today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the UK employment report of the UK employment report for October, which came in better than expected. However, the report passed unnoticed by GBP traders, confirming our view that the only game in town for them is Brexit. Later in the day, we have Canada's housing starts and the US industrial production, both for November. Canada's housing starts are expected to have held relatively steady, while the US industrial production is anticipated to have slowed to 0.3% month over month from 1.1%. With regards to the energy market, we get the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week, but as it is always the case, no forecast is available. We also have two speakers on the agenda, and those are ECB Chief Economist Philip Lane and Bank of Canada Governor Tiff Macklin. So that's it for me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.